What's going on, guys? Today we'll be going over all the new features in World of Chill and ESHL. First thing I actually want to point out is just the new menus in NHL 22. I think they look incredible. I really like the fact that they're actually using real life footage from the NHL on these menus. It just looks so much sharper, I think, than, you know, footage from the game or just no footage at all. So obviously it's showing off like the new X Factor, but I just think it looks really clean. Even at the end there, the autograph, the black and white, looks really good. I actually posted screenshots of the new menu on my Instagram, and someone mentioned how the up and down menu reminds them of NHL on 360, and I have to agree, and I kind of referred that menu, I think, to like the tiles we've had the past few years, and without a doubt, like, we just needed to change no matter what it was, and I think this was a really nice one. Now, speaking of the new menu in regards to NHL 22, we also have a new menu for the World of Chill. This one looks a lot cleaner. On the main screen, you can immediately jump into a game, whether it be Pro-Am, 3's Eliminator, 1's Eliminator, ESHL drop-ins, club. As you can see, your guy skating there. He's got like the cool background behind him. It'll actually change to like your club's rank once you join a club. I don't think right now, but I feel like just looking at the space there, I'm getting Fortnite vibes. I feel like in the future, when someone joins your party, they'll probably show up on the ice next to you. Like, when I see that, I see kind of like the Fortnite load-in screen, or I think Apex is very similar. Speaking of which, you can see like the kind of party invite thing in the top right. You can actually invite people to your party from the main screen before you even get into a dressing room. And then, you know, if you have three guys, you can get into a threes game. And then let's say you come out of that threes game, the rest of your friends are ready to play, you can immediately go to a sixes game. Like, it's very, very cool, this new menu. Also, while you're waiting in the dressing room, you can completely edit your loadout, customize your player, even like look at your stats in ESHL. So again, just so much more improved to what we've had the last few years. And speaking of customization, guys, World of Chill is now using an all new customization system. As well, they actually have new attribute categories. I'm not sure if this is gonna span across all modes. So if your guys in franchise and HUD, we'll also have their attributes split into these categories. We'll have to wait and see, but starting off with technique, you have your two shot accuracies, speed, balance, agility. Power is the two shot powers, excel, puck control, endurance. Playstyle is passing, offensive, defensive awareness, body checking, stick checking. Tenacity there, hand eye, strength, durability, shot block. I feel like body checking should probably be in tenacity, but who am I to say? Tactics there, you have deking, face-offs, discipline, and fighting skill. Again, I'm not sure how does fighting skill go into tactics. That should also be in tenacity. I really don't think a lot of tactics go into getting into a fight, but who knows? So the first thing you guys will notice, of course, is the X factors. You have zone abilities right here. The one shown is 1T. So apparently, certain zone abilities will only go with certain player classes. So 1T, of course, increased your one timer. That definitely fits the sniper class, but you probably can't put a 1T on like an enforcer defense and something like that. Now the superstar abilities, though, you can put on any player you want. The only thing is you actually have to meet a threshold of a minimum stat. So for instance, if you want 1T, you might need a minimum of 80 slap shot accuracy, something like that. After that, you actually have the boost. This is an all new trait system to ESHL in NHL 22, and it's literally just a free boost to a stat of your choice. It could be a +2 to speed, +2 to wrist shot accuracy, +2 passing, things like that. And you get two of those, absolutely no drawbacks, but just like the superstar abilities, they also have a minimum stat requirement in order to use them. Now, on top of the new X Factor customization, guys, you can actually now edit your individual stats again. This is something the community's been asking for a while. Now, there are limits to this, but I think it's a really cool system they're using. Basically, it has to do with each attribute category. So looking at technique here, you can see wrist shot accuracy has a cost of 30. Slap shot accuracy 20, speed 40, because it's probably the most important stat, balance 30, agility 30. So you can go in and edit those stats to a max of +5 or -5. Of course, minusing it will give you extra points to spend. Adding, of course, will take away your points. So right here you can see they've gone -3 on wrist shot accuracy, -3 slap shot accuracy, -1 agility, +4 balance, +1 speed. So you probably could get your speed +5, but you're gonna be like -3 everywhere else to kind of afford it. As again, it's the most expensive one, but it probably would be worth it. So very curious to see what kind of classes people can build now with all this added customization. As well, on top of that, they actually have a description for each stat now. So agility, you can see, determines your turn radius and how quickly you can decelerate slash stop and change directions. This is a big thing for, I think, offensive defensive awareness. Everyone's always wondering what those things did. So offensive awareness there handles your reaction time and field of view in offensive scenarios. For example, how quickly you react to pick up a loose puck or reaction time to a pass from a teammate. And then defensive awareness there determines reaction time and field of view for pass interceptions distributions and acquiring loose pucks lost by your opponent. So the fact that it actually tells you now what every stat does, I think is very cool. Also guys, another thing I want to mention with the new stat categories is we're actually missing two stats, but one of them did basically nothing. That's probably why it's not here. That's poise. You'll see there's no poise stat, as well there's no aggressiveness stat. Now, I feel like the reason there's no aggressiveness stat is because a lot of people actually saw it as a negative stat, like your guy would get more penalties, goalies would be more out of position. So they just completely got rid of that one, and then like I said, poise didn't really do anything, I don't think, in ESHL, so I think that's why they got rid of that one as well. And on top of all this, you can still adjust your height and weight, and doing so will further adjust your stats. Obviously, a heavier guy is slower but stronger. A lighter guy is faster but weaker. So again, I think there's gonna be so much more customization options here in NHL 22 than we've seen, you know, the past literally 5-6 years in ESHL. As well too, it says that there'll be new superstar abilities and boosts added every season. So hopefully you can see the meta changing when they add new stuff. I'm not really sure, you know, how creative they can be with that, but maybe it's some really cool thing. But I guess we'll just have to wait and see. Also, guys, there's a few more things I want to mention before I end the video. The first is that they actually added a reduced club final. A lot of people said the club final is way too long. They reduced it as well. You're right now playing on white ice in that club final. I think the white ice was a much needed change, so glad to see them do that. As well, on top of that, when you're searching for games, you can actually adjust exactly what you want the size difference to be for the other club, and the range on that is a plus or minus of 4. So if you have a club of 2, you can say, you know, I'll play a club of 3 or 4 but not 5-6. And of course, you know, the reverse, if you have a 6-man club, you're willing to play 4-5-6-man clubs but not, you know, 3-2-man clubs. Very cool to see just that added accuracy. And finally guys, the last thing that's actually pretty big for tournaments is you can now restrict replay skipping. So if you're watching a stream and, you know, whatever person's point of view they're using for that stream decides to accidentally skip a replay, maybe that would be really nice for the viewers to watch. They can actually restrict that now to make sure all the replays are there. So again, not really going to affect the casual player, but for watching streams of big tournaments, that is a huge plus. And finally, guys, the NHL 22 beta, or the closed technical test, it's technically called, comes out tomorrow, August 30th. So hopefully you guys signed up. If not, I will actually be having codes to give away. So make sure you guys are following me on Twitter, on Instagram. I'll be giving you guys tons of codes to make sure you get in there and, you know, trying out NHL 22 for yourselves. But that's gonna be it, guys, for this video. Hopefully you enjoyed this one. If you did, give me that thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed yet, hit the sub button. Thank you guys so much for watching. Have a nice day. Goodbye.